In this video, we will see some of the tools that help you work faster with CAD layers in ARES Commander. For example, we can hide a layer just by selecting an entity located on that layer, or activate all layers at once. We can even lock a layer just by selecting an entity that belongs to it. Of course, we can also unlock layers by selecting one or more entities at a time. All of these tools help us to work faster with layers. One of my favorites is the isolate layer command that allows isolating the layer of selected entities. All the other layers will be hidden. You can run the unisolate layer command to revert back to the changes. We can also use this other feature to define the active layer by selecting an entity, which can be very helpful. With Change Entities layer, we can move an entity to another layer by selecting a second entity belonging to the new layer. See also how I will change the active layer by simply selecting an entity. In this other example, we will use the Entity to Active Layer command. And after selecting an entity, we see that it is now moved to the active layer. Easy, isn't it? Next, we will select this group of entities currently belonging to the layer Bungalows 1. And with the command LAYERDELETE, we can delete the layer to which the entities belong. Yes, ARES Commander allows you to delete a layer and all its content. This is why ARES Commander asks you to confirm by yes or no before deleting the content. As you can see, the Bungalows 1 layer has now disappeared along with its content. To learn more about the many productivity features of ARES Commander, do not hesitate to visit our website www.graebert.com or take a look at our help files.